My name is Rebecca White. I'm from Wilder, Vermont, and I am the recently elected Hartford Select Board member. So the Hartford Select Board, I've always been very interested in local government, and that was something that really drove me to run for the Hartford Select Board. But the biggest motivating factor was just the fact that I don't see any young people or anyone even marginally close to my age in politics in Vermont. I saw that even though we're working on minority rights and we're working on more people being involved in politics and having representation, there was this whole group of people who I'm a part of, which is people age 25 or under, that just aren't being present in those conversations. And I thought, hey, why not? The select board seems like the right first step. There's a lot of open vacancies on different boards throughout the town. And I thought, you know what, just go be appointed to one of those. That'll be really easy, your first step when you come back home. Because I'm currently a UVM, so I wanted something that would transition me back to living in Hartford. From Burlington, and then I saw that there was the election, and then I saw that the incumbent wasn't running, which is Ken Parker, who I replaced his seat for the two-year position, and I thought, you know, I'm really interested in this, and actually maybe I should just go for it. Ken Parker had a quote from the Valley News, which said, you know, the next person should be someone who's global thinking and forward thinking. And I just thought, wow, that's a sign. I should do this. There we go. I'm in. I'm doing it. So that's when I really made the decision to just kind of go and wholeheartedly run. I realized that I was running against two people who were much older than me, who are also more established in the community, just even for the fact that I was born and have always lived in Wilder. I hadn't necessarily been around for the last 6 years, or I really haven't been a big player. You know, when you're in high school, you don't really get the opportunity to hobnob with like local decision makers. They don't really have much of a concern about your opinion. So I realized at that point that I was going to need to have a different perspective on Hartford as a town. So my campaign strategy was really to just go out and say, okay, the two candidates who are running against me, which is Mike Morris and Dennis Brown, I just went into it and said, hey, you know, I'm not either of those two people. I'm very different. I'm the choice that's separate from those two. So if you want something that's going to change Hartford, or at least have the ability to change Hartford, that's the person you want to vote for. So I have a lot of experience with actually knocking on doors and saying, hey, my name is Rebecca. How about you consider this? It was a completely different experience to knock on someone's door and go and say, hey, support the environment or clean heat or solar power. It was, hey, I'm awesome. Why don't you vote for me? I'm great. I set up a Facebook page, which I actually think I was the only person running who set up a Facebook page, which was actually really successful. I got a local person, Noah Detzer, if he's watching. He filmed my campaign video, which was really fun.
Hi, my name is Rebecca White, and I'm running for Hartford Town Select Board. I grew up right here in Hartford, so I know all the issues that are important to Hartford voters.
We went around to all the different villages and got like shots of me being like, yay, Hartford. So that was good.
And my goal is to get even more people involved. So vote for me, Rebecca White, for Hartford Town Select Board.
So I tried to do it a little differently than what the classic just put out signs in your yard way that campaigning tends to go. So something a little different. But looking back now, I had thought it was not going to be, I actually didn't think I was going to win after that day, because he just had so much overwhelming support from the community. And if you saw his signs, he had a lot of signs. I felt like he beat me in the sign department. So that was mentally and physically difficult. Well, life as a select board member isn't that different than being a regular citizen. The biggest difference is that every other Tuesday I have the meetings, and then I read the news far more carefully. That's the first biggest thing. And I also just am, I read the listserv as well. There's a Hartford listserv, you should all be on it. But the biggest changes that I want to make in Hartford are probably three big things. And the first one is something that I campaigned on. In fact, all three I campaigned on, unsurprisingly. The first one is just synchronicity between the school board and the town board. And the way I've really tried to work on that is I'm already the school board liaison to the select board, which means that I attend the meetings for the school board, and really I'm the moderator, or the communicator between the two boards. And then the second really big thing I wanted to do was just get more awareness to young people being involved in the process, as well as just more people who may not already be involved. You know, it's not just age 25 and under, it's people who might not be long-term residents of Hartford or might be new to the community, that might not have that family background of, oh yeah, we know who the select board members are, we know who the town manager is. It's people who don't have that interaction as consistently as a lot of more long-term members of the community do. So getting them more involved, which has been really challenging. The biggest thing that I'd like to do, you know, I've got 2 years, is to just get as much public awareness to attending the select board meetings, knowing that you can always come to me. The biggest way that I've done that so far is I put my phone number out there, and I said, hey, give me a call if you want to talk about anything. So far, I have gotten very few calls, but that's still an open door if anyone wants to talk about something. And then the last really big thing that I wanted to do, so I'm very concerned about climate change and the environment and the impact that it'll have on future generations. And that's something that we as a community, I think, need to take as a priority moving forward. So I'm already the liaison to the Energy Commission, which was just I just took over that position as well. So making sure that Hartford is looking, when we're building infrastructure or when we're considering projects, or even when we're looking at fixing old problems, you know, are we doing it in a sustainable way that really reflects the values of our community? Yeah, oh, and the budget. Let's not make that expensive. I think that's just an automatic. I'd like to not have a huge increase in taxes.